This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so in our last session, we discussed about the enterprise structure where we created a company code and then we assigned the global parameters to company code like chart of account, fiscal year variant, field status variant, and posting period variant. And we have seen there is no change in the fiscal year variant and field status variant, but when it comes to chart of accounts and the posting period variant, there are some few changes. So in chart of accounts, when we create a chart of account, we don't have any option to specify whether the cost element should be created manually or automatically, because the cost element is now merged within GL. And second change that we have seen is when we were creating the account groups, so even for the secondary cost elements, we need to create an account group now. In ECC, we were not creating the account group for secondary cost elements because those were only created in CO, not in FI. But now they are created in both FI as well as CO, and that is the reason we need to create an account group. So that was a change which was related to chart of account. And in terms of posting period variant, there was one change that instead of two period intervals, in SAP S/4HANA, SAP provides third period interval now. And the purpose of that third period interval is for CO postings, which comes from CO to FI. So earlier, OKP1 transaction was used to control the controlling postings. But now, since even if you post anything in controlling, that will also come to FI. So OKP1 is not enough. We also need to have this OB52 in the third interval. Okay, so that third interval is relevant for postings from CO to FI. Okay, and then we have seen the difference in terms of ledgers. Okay, so now in ledger setting, when we are creating the ledgers, earlier we were only providing the option of the ledger code description, whether the ledger is a leading ledger or a non-leading ledger, and fourth one was the totals table. Now there is no concept of totals table. You don't need to provide any totals table. And in terms of ledger, earlier there were only two types. There were only two types, that is leading ledger, non-leading ledger. But both these type of ledgers were standard ledgers. Okay, so let me open the screen. So if I go to SPRO, let's go to IMG. So in financial settings, again, financial accounting global settings, the path is same. Within the ledger, you'll be able to see the ledger, but these activities are different. Within the ledger folder, you will find some of these activities are which are available in ECC are no more available, and there are some new activities. Okay, so if I click on define settings for ledger and currency types, okay, you can see here you have this different ledgers. So you can provide the ledger code, you can provide the ledger number, and you can provide whether it is a leading ledger or not. But apart from this, all these other columns, they were not available in SAP ECC. Okay, so there was only fourth column, which was totals table, and totals table is no more available in S/4HANA. And in terms of ledger types, earlier there was only leading, non-leading, but both leading as well as non-leading ledgers were created as standard ledgers. Okay, now there is a new concept of extension ledger. This extension ledger is only available in SAP S/4HANA, and this extension ledger would be only for non-leading ledgers. Okay, leading ledger will always be the standard ledger. You cannot create a leading ledger as an extension ledger. Leading ledger will be always the standard ledger, but apart from the leading ledger, whenever you are creating any non-leading ledger, you have a choice whether you want to create it as a standard or you want to create it as an extension ledger. Okay, again, if you are creating it as a standard ledger, no need to specify anything here because these are further classifications of extension ledger. So when you select an extension ledger, then you have to specify whether it is a normal extension ledger or it is a simulation ledger or is it a valuation ledger or this is a prediction and commitment ledger. Okay, so when SAP came up with SAP's S/4HANA's first version, Simple Finance. In that, there were only categories, standard ledger and extension ledger. There were not these types. Okay, then in 1610 and 1709, SAP came up with this extension ledger and simulation ledger, only two. Now, only in 1809, just 3-4 months back, when SAP released this new SAP S/4HANA version, they included this prediction and valuation ledger. Okay, so we'll talk about this in detail, but as of now, just remember what are the different four types of extension ledgers, and within the ledger, there are two types, standard ledger and extension ledger. One more thing, whenever you are creating a extension ledger will always contain an underlying ledger. Okay, so this underlying ledger is not required if the ledger is standard. This will be only required if your ledger type is extension. Okay, what is the role, what exactly it will do? We will see when we'll do some transactions. Okay, and then I told you, whatever number of ledgers you create, your leading ledger will by default be assigned to each and every company code. So whenever you create a new company code in the system, by default, leading ledger is active. See, if the leading ledger is also not active, then what is the purpose of company code, right? Any company code which you are creating in the system, it has to perform some accounting and it has to perform some accounting principles, right? So at least one accounting principle is by default active for each company code. And that is the reason whenever you create a new company code, by default, leading ledger will be assigned to that company code. But apart from the leading ledger, whatever non-leading ledgers you are able to see here, those are not mandatory. Okay, those are all optional. You can decide which one you want to use for your company code and which one you don't want to use. And that too here specific. So you can say, okay, I want to use ledger IFRS only for 2018 and 19. Starting from 2020, I don't want to use IFRS. Okay, so in other configuration here, you can deactivate a ledger for a company code. So if you go here, let's say I want to deactivate ledger IF from this particular date. So you have to specify 2 year here. Okay, so what will happen? When you say 2 year is 2019, this means it will be only applicable till 2019. In 2020, this ledger will not work. Okay, so that is the whole definition of what are ledgers and all. Again, let me go to the screen. Now, in SAP ECC, when we talk about the currencies, there were three currencies in total. The first one was the company code currency, and then there were two parallel currencies which can be assigned to the company code. Apart from that, there was fourth currency, which was a controlling area currency. But now in SAP S/4HANA, you still have company code currency, and you still have, okay, let me just double click on this. Let's go to a particular company code. So let's say our company code is F01. Okay, and here you can see I already shown you last time. So you have a company code currency, you have a controlling area currency. Now in SAP S/4HANA, the number of parallel currencies which were restricted to two earlier, we have up to 8 currencies. Okay, so it is not mandatory that you have to use it, it is up to you. Okay, so nobody is saying that you need to use 8 currencies. It is just the additional flexibility which is provided by SAP. If you want to activate it, you can activate it from here. Okay, so let's say whenever you want to add a new currency, let's say I want to add a new currency, I'll go for currency. Now system will give me the list of all the currency types. Again, if you do this thing in SAP ECC also, when you click on F4, system will give you the option of group currency, hard currency, index currency. These are normal three options which are available in ECC. But here if you do F4, you may find more number of currencies. Okay, not only hard currency, group currency and all, you may find more number of that, because even you can create your own currency types. In ECC, it was not possible. In ECC, whatever currency types were available, they were provided in standard and you cannot create your own. So normally we were only using hard currency or group currency or index-based currency. But here you can create your own currencies. How you can do it? So you can see before you come to the ledger settings, there are three activities which are related to the currency types. Okay, so if I want to add a new currency, what I'll do, I'll double click on the currency type. You can see there are a lot of currency types which are not provided by SAP actually. These are currency types many consultants who are practicing on this server have created. Normally, SAP will only provide you the standard currency types, but if you want to create your own, you can easily create. Okay, so whenever you want to create a currency type, again, you will be clicking on a new entry. You just provide a two-digit character number. This has to be alphanumeric, which means you can have combination of alpha plus numeric, or it can be only numeric, or it can be only alpha also. Okay, so two-digit code. You can provide a description, a short description, and this is again just for the information purpose. This will not make any difference in terms of the postings. Okay, and one important thing here is this one, settings for default level. Okay, so here you are specifying that this currency which you are creating, is this going to be based on the company code, or this is going to be based on the global? Global means, for example, if I want to restrict hard currency as USD for all the company codes in the system, it should not happen that if I go to company code A, hard currency is USD, and if I go to company code B, hard currency is Euro. Okay, so you can decide whether you want to keep this currency types as company code specific or global. Okay, so these are all additional flexibilities provided by system. It is not mandatory to use them, but yes, if you come across a situation when there is a need for the customer to create parallel currencies, you can obviously go here and you can create according to the business requirements. Okay, so here is a place where you can create different currency types. If you go to the second one, which is global currency convergence settings. So global currency convergence setting means out of this, there are some currencies which are global and some currencies which are company code specific. So for global currencies, this is a config. And for company code specific, this is a config. Okay, so you can go to global currency convergence, and here you can specifically write the global currency. Okay, so for example, Y1 would be always Euro for all the company codes. Okay, Y5, if you are using currency type, it will be always USD, irrespective of which company you are using, because globally this is defined. Now the question is, why then these currencies are not fixed? These are not fixed because they are based on company code and controlling object. Okay, you cannot change this. These currency types cannot be changed, but they will be based on the company codes that you are creating. Okay, so in short, there are some currencies which are global currencies, and there are some currencies which are company code specific currencies. Okay, so you can see these are some company code specific settings where you can specify for which company code, okay, so which currency types you want to use. Okay, so for example, let's say if I want to go for a new entry, I have to first specify the company code. So let's say our company code is SF01, okay, and which currency type I want to use. Let's say I want to go for group currency and I want to specify this as USD. Okay, and then normal thing which you are even doing in SAP ECC also. So what would be the source currency type? It would be always the document currency, right? So whenever you are posting the document, that document currency will be converted to the group currency, right? In terms of exchange rate type, normally we were using M. The standard exchange rate type is M. And what would be the translation date? So normally the translation date was date type was a, I think it was a translation date, yes. So based on the date on which you are doing the transaction, system will go for that particular date. Okay, so just press enter. Now you can use this currency 30 in your company code. Okay, so let's try to save this. These are just the warning message. There should not be any red mark. If there is any red mark, then the system will not allow you to save this. Okay, so just click on save. Okay, Okay, and finally, now if I come to ledger, and within ledger, if I go to 0L, which is our standard ledger, leading ledger, go to company code settings in SF01. What I can do now, if I do F4 now, you can see this 30 has been added. Earlier, this was not appearing because only global currencies were appearing. Now we added a company code specific currency for our company code SF01, and that is the reason we are able to see this option here. So just double click on this, press enter. System will automatically pick the data. This is the same message that you were even getting in SAP ECC also when you try to create a new currency for your company code. Okay, so you can see this information has been copied. If you want to see more information, you can see this is a currency type, this is a source currency type, this is exchange rate type, this is a translation date type, whether it is a real-time conversion or the conversion will happen after that. Okay, so normally we go for the real-time conversion only. Is there any deviation in CO? I'll talk about this deviation in CO, deviation in AA, deviation in material. So we will talk about these things, but as of now, just remember you can add up to 8 currencies, and the currency types are also user defined. You can create the currency types as company code specific, or you can create it as a global. Okay, just click on save. Okay, so any question till now? And last thing, I've shown you accounting principles. So which means if you are creating your ledger, so you have to specify this ledger represents which accounting principle. So what we are telling to the system is 0L means India GAAP. IF means IFRS. Okay, so if I want to know the IFRS reporting, system will know that, okay, if you are looking for IFRS reporting, you should go for ledger IF. And if you are using for India GAAP reporting, you should go to ledger 0L. Okay, that is just for the representation purpose. And the last thing that we also discussed that day is what exactly is this tick? What do you mean by parallel accounting using GL accounts? So if you remember, I told you parallel accounting using GL accounts means in SAP ECC, if you are having the requirement of India GAAP and IFRS, but let's say you are not using new GL accounting. So in that case, companies traditionally, they used to create different accounts. Okay, so same account, let's say for example, if it's an asset account, there will be two separate asset accounts created, one for your India GAAP and second is for your IFRS. And whenever you want to do the reporting, you will include those particular accounts based on the accounting principle. That is called as an account-based approach, which is called as parallel accounting using GL accounts. But if you are not using parallel accounting using GL accounts, we are using parallel accounting using different ledgers. And that is the reason we are not ticking here. Now, who will tick here? Obviously, if more advanced features like ledgers are available, nobody would like to create the GLs, right? But I will tell you in which case customers will need this parallel accounting using GL accounts. The customers who are currently using classic GL accounting, okay, very old customers, they are still not using new GL accounting, although new GL accounting is more than 15 years old now, more than 13 years old. But still the customers are using classic GL accounting and they only have one ledger. And they are already doing the parallel accounting using GL accounts. So even if they want to come to SAP S/4HANA, okay, and they want to continue using the same thing that they are using in SAP ECC on classic GL accounting, only those customers would like to go with parallel accounting using GL accounts. Okay, let me add one real-time scenario which Akash was discussing me with yesterday. Akash was about to, he actually was working on one proposal where customer asked what exactly will be the changes in SAP new GL accounting compared to classic GL accounting, and what will happen if I go to SAP S/4HANA without activating new GL accounting. Right, Akash, that was one slide that you put in yesterday. Yes,
Yes,
so let me tell you, let me again confirm what I said, which will be helpful for others also whenever they come across the situation. Okay, please understand what I'm saying here. Although I'm going to talk about this topic in detail, but let me just give you some real-time scenario. So let's say you are working on, let's say a customer is already using SAP ECC system, but he is not using new GL accounting. He's using classic GL accounting. Now, when we say classic GL accounting, this means only one ledger. Okay, so customer is, what he is doing is, he is doing parallel accounting using GL accounts, which is also called as account-based approach. Okay, now if this customer wants to migrate to SAP S/4HANA, now customer wants to upgrade his system to S/4HANA. He in SAP S/4HANA, he will get two options. Option number one is first migrate to new GL accounting and then to S/4HANA accounting. Okay, the second option is directly migrate to S/4HANA accounting without activating new GL accounting. Okay, so what will happen in the first case, if customer migrates to new GL accounting first, he will introduce more ledgers. Okay, so he will go away from parallel accounting using GL accounts and he will be using parallel ledgers. Okay, and then move to SAP S/4HANA. So if he is following the first option, which is the recommended option, so customer would be able to use parallel ledgers instead of parallel GL accounts, which was the old functionality. But if he directly goes to SAP S/4HANA accounting without activating the new GL accounting, so even in SAP S/4HANA also, this customer has to use only one ledger and he has to follow the account-based approach. So this option is for those customers who are directly planning to migrate to S/4HANA accounting. They don't want to first go to new GL accounting and then to S/4. They want to first go to SAP S/4HANA accounting and later on they will decide whether they want to activate new GL accounting or not. Right, so in those scenarios, this tick is very important because when we are configuring the system, we have to indicate or we have to tick this indicator just to tell the system that this customer is although going to SAP S/4HANA accounting, but he still wants to use one ledger. He just want to use parallel accounting using GL accounts. Okay, any questions till now before I go to the next one?
So Gaurav, Sandeep here.
Yes, Sandeep.
So this option is only coming for reading ledger, or you can see this tick for the non-reading, that means extension ledger.
Now, see, logically, Sandeep, when we are saying there is only one ledger, this option will be ticked when there is only one ledger. And if there is only one ledger, it is obviously going to be leading ledger, right?
Yeah, that is logically that is correct. Yeah. So, but is it available in extension?
Yes, although it is, let's see if it is available or not, but it is completely illogical, right? Even if it is available. Yeah, it is available, but we don't need this. When we are saying that parallel accounting using GL accounts, this itself means that we are not going to create multiple ledgers. We are only going to create one ledger, and that ledger will be used for all the different accounting principles. Okay, so yes, so as I told you, logically, if you go, there is only one leading ledger which will be created if you are ticking this indicator. Other ledgers will even not be created. See, this is a test system. Somebody has created a lot of ledgers, but when you are actually migrating the system from classic GL accounting, you will not be able to see any ledgers at all. It will just show you one single ledger, that is nothing but 0L.
Yes. Okay.
Okay, so now let me take you to the next step. So now we understood what are ledgers, what are currency settings. So there are a lot of new things here in the ledger concept. Now let's try to go into controlling. Okay, so we set up the enterprise structure from the FI perspective. Now let's try to set up it from the CEO perspective. So I'll go to controlling. Okay, general controlling. Organization maintain controlling area. So same path that we were using in ECC. Even if you want to create a controlling area, again you will be going to the new entry and you will be specifying this one SF01. Okay, so whatever you want to create, this is just for example. And I'm currently, let's say I'm using controlling area same as company code. So again the same thing that in ECC also you have these two options. So when you create a controlling area, system asks you whether this controlling area will be shared with multiple company codes or this is going to be one to one. Okay, so as of now, I'm saying one to one. I will be selecting the currency type here. So currency type, if you are using controlling area same as company code, it will only give you one option. If you select cross company code controlling area, system will give you the controlling area option, cost object option. So there will be multiple options available. So let's use this. System has automatically determined that for this particular company code, you assign the currency as INR, a chart of account as SF01 and fiscal year variant as V3. Okay, and again, similar to ECC, it is asking you cost center standard hierarchy, which will be used for creating the cost centers. So again, let's say if I'm providing this SF01 and press enter, everything is same. See, again, in ECC also, you have the same thing. So if I click on yes, system will create this SF01 also in the background. Okay, so just click on save. Again, I'm pressing yes. So our controlling area is created, but we need to perform two other things also, which is first one, we need to specify we need to assign the company codes to this controlling area. So let's go to the new entry and specify SF01. Okay, so this is the first thing. And second thing, we need to activate the components. Okay, so in CO, we know there are a lot of components like cost center accounting, profit center accounting, profitability analysis, product costing, internal orders. There are a lot of things, right? So we need to specify which components are active. So I'm doing this from 2018. Okay, and as of now, let's say I'm just activating the cost center accounting component. All these components I'm not activating as of now. So just click on save. The common thing, even in ECC also, you'll get this indicator. Okay, so the controlling area has now been created and it has been assigned to the company codes and even the components are now active. Okay, let's go to the next one now. So if I created a controlling area, the next thing I must do is...
Gaurav, one...
Yes.
Can you go to the main screen again, the controlling area screen?
Controlling area screen, okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Go to that, our controlling area.
Mm-hmm.
So what is that field, hide controlling area in F4 in other settings? Is that a new field?
Yes. I'll come back to you on this. There are some fields, but I don't want to get confused here. I'll tell you this one.
Okay, go on. Okay.
Okay, maybe if you ask, let's see. This is if I go for F1. So what it is saying is no, it is not giving you any information. So it is just for hiding. When you do the F4, which means when you do the list of values, whether you want to show this value or not, but I'll show you during the transactions. Okay.
Oh, okay.
You may find, see, when you go through the screens, there are some places where you may find new fields or some of the fields are not available. But I'm just focusing on the important fields which are not available earlier and which has a huge difference in SAP S/4HANA. Okay, so let me go back. Save the changes, no. Okay, so normally once we create the controlling area, we have this option of maintain number ranges for controlling, that is KANK, and we maintain the versions. So let's complete this, then we will talk about the other things. Let's go to the maintain number ranges. So this is our controlling area, which is SF01. So instead of doing it from scratch, what I normally even do in the projects also is I copy from 0001 to SF01. Instead of creating all the number ranges from scratch, I'm just copying it from 0001 to SF01. So now if I go for SF01 and click on intervals, see, this has been copied from 0001. Okay, and the last one is maintain the versions. So normally this zero version is something which we use for posting the values from FI to CU. Okay, and let me see if there is anything else that we need to enter here. No, I think this is enough. Let's come out. Now, this is something that you will not find in SAP ECC. Define ledger for CO version. Okay, define ledger for CO version. Let me tell you, let me give you the background of this activity. See, when we were working on SAP ECC, normally when we say primary postings, or primary cost element postings to be very specific. So what do you mean by primary cost element postings? Is when you do any transaction in FI, it flows into CU. Okay. Now, let's say you are doing the transaction in leading ledger and you are doing the transaction in IFRS also. In FI, you have two ledgers, 0L and IF. Now, when these postings will go from FI to CO, can you tell me the postings will go from ledger 0L or they will go from IFRS or they will go from both? I'm asking you from ECC perspective. In ECC, whenever we post anything in FI, it also goes to CO. Now, in ECC, if I have two ledgers, 0L and IFRS, if I do any postings here, this will go to both the ledgers. So now, if they are going to both the ledgers, what will happen to CO? In CO also, do we have ledgers? Do we have ledgers in CO?
No, Gaurav. So whatever posting is, yes.
Okay, so what do you think? Values from 0L will go to CO or values from IF will go to CO?
No, 0L. By default, 0L value will go to the CO. So I hope this is a new addition. We can choose the like, what ledger should impact in controlling area.
Okay, yes. So in SAP ECC, it is only possible to send the values from leading ledger to CO. Okay, so even if you want to send IFRS values, even if you want to send any values from any other ledger to CO, that is not possible in SAP ECC because it is always taking the values from the leading ledger. Only leading ledger, this is very specifically written in the new GL document also of SAP ECC. Only leading ledger can transport the values from FI to CO. No other ledger has capability to pick the values from FI and post it into the CO in terms of SAP ECC. But now when we are talking about SAP S/4HANA, we can decide what values can go from FI to CO, which ledgers will post from FI to CO. So similar to ledgers in FI, in CO we have different versions. Okay, this is also available in ECC. We have different versions. So we can say, let's say we create version 0 and we create version 9. So we can tell the system that whatever we post in 0L, in CO, it should go to version 0. And whatever we post to version IF in CO, it should be posted to version 9. Okay, So this particular thing again was not available in SAP ECC. In SAP ECC, this was default and there was no configuration to do this. It was by default in the system. Only leading ledger 0L was posting the values to version 0, CO version 0, and there was no other version which was taking the values from FI. Okay, but now since this thing is possible, system is asking you, you want which ledger to post the versions in which CO version. So at least one entry is mandatory here, that is your leading ledger. If I click on new entry, so for controlling area SF01, okay, version 0 of CO will take the values from leading ledger, that is 0L. Okay, so this entry is mandatory. If you don't do this, system will not allow you to post anything. This is a new configuration and this is must configuration, without which system will not allow you to go ahead and create any postings in FI and CO. Okay, so just click on save and this is done. So this is called as define ledger for CO version. So which CO version will take the values from which ledger, you can define here. Okay, now this is also something which was also available in SAP ECC, but it was not directly available here. This is subsequent assignment of controlling area. So for example, when you created a company code, it was not assigned to any controlling area. But now after doing a lot of transactions in company code, if you want to assign it to the controlling area with the previous postings also, in that case, this is not a very straightforward job. This has to be done by the SAP support. Okay, so just forget about this as of now. This is in short a complete different project to activate the controlling area subsequently. Okay, it is just like subsequent document splitting, which is also the new GL functionality, which itself is a project. Okay, so just don't worry about this. This was even possible in SAP ECC also, but the folder was not available in between here. But this is something which is completely new, which was not available in SAP ECC, which is only available in S/4HANA. Okay, so let's go out from here now. So we now created a controlling area with number ranges and versions. Let's close this also. And now maybe I think we are ready to create some master data. Okay, we will again come to the configuration related to the transactions when we'll do the transaction. But let's now see what are the changes in the GL master. Okay, so what I'll do is I will go to transaction FS00, which was a transaction that we were using even in SAP ECC also. If you just go to FS00, this is the same, almost same transaction. There will be a lot of changes here which we'll talk about, but look and feel is almost same. Like you have a type description, you have a control data, so even the tabs and all are exactly same. But if I want to create a cost element, so we were using this transaction KA01, so if I press enter, it is also going to take you to the same transaction, that is FS00. So even if I go for K01, if I press enter, it will take me to FS00, because KA01, which was related to creation of cost element, is not available separately. Okay, it has been merged with FS00. Okay, and now if I want to create a new GL, yes, any question? There was some background noise.
Yes, Gaurav, Sandeep here.
Yes.
So, right now also there have no option for creating GL account under chart of account, right? Through, I think, SP01 transition code.
No, sorry. Can you come again, Sandeep?
So right now there is no option for creating GL account under chart of account.
No, that options are available. So you can still go.
Okay.
You mean to say this GL account, this transaction FSP0, so you can create at the chart of account level.
Okay, yeah, that's right. Yeah.
This is not changed. So even in ECC also, we had two segments for GL account: chart of account segment and company code segment. So that still remains same. Only thing is separate transaction to maintain the cost element is no more required. Okay, so cost elements are merged within the GL. That is the change. So let's again go to FS00 and let's try to create a new GL account. Okay, so I think we used four characters, 1 3 times 0, starting with 1 3 times 0, where we created the account groups. So let's say I want to use 2000 for our company code, which is SF01. Okay, and let's click on new. I want to create a new GL. Now system is asking me, the first field it is asking me is to provide a GL account type. Do you think this SAP ECC to specify the GL account type? What do you think? This field was available in ECC?
No.
It was not there, right? System was directly asking us the account group. It was not asking for GL account type. This GL account type, yeah, this GL account type is a new field and it has four values out of which you have to select the proper value. Okay, so the first one is non-operating expenses or income. Okay, let's read out all four and then I'll tell you the difference. Second one is primary cost or revenue. Third one is secondary cost. And fourth one is balance sheet account. So in short, all your balance sheet accounts, whenever you are creating any new GL for balance sheet account, we will always use this balance sheet account. And as I told you, also in SAP S/4HANA, whenever you are creating the secondary cost elements, you need to create a GL account, right? So whenever you want to create a GL account for secondary cost elements, you have to use this. Okay, so you have to go for secondary cost whenever you are creating a secondary cost element. Now remaining two, both are relevant to expenses. You can see this is also expense and income. This is also cost or revenue. So expense is cost, income is revenue. So there is no difference, right? Primary or non-operating. Only difference is whenever you create a GL account, if you are creating the cost element, see, when you create a profit and loss GL account, in some of the cases, you don't need to create a cost element out of it. It is not mandatory for all the GL accounts, all the profit and loss GL accounts to create a cost element. There are some GL accounts which are non-operating. Non-operating means those will not go to CO. They will only remain in FI. Okay, so for example, cost of goods sold. So cost of goods sold, normally we don't create any cost element of it. Scrap sales, even scrap sales is something which is our non-operating income. Okay, so there are some GL accounts for which we create them as expense or revenue accounts, but we don't create the cost element for it. Okay, so if you want to create a cost element for profit and loss account, you have to select this. If you don't want to create the cost element for profit and loss accounts, you have to select this non-operating expense or income. So these two are relevant for profit and loss. This is relevant for secondary cost element and this is relevant for balance sheet accounts. So based on what exactly you are creating, you will be selecting the proper account type. Okay, so let's say for example, I will go with balance sheet account because 2000 is my, let's say, cash account. Account group, this is the same functionality of SAP ECC where you have to provide the account group based on which system will determine the number range and it will also determine the the field control, like which fields will be mandatory, which fields will be optional. So obviously this account group, according to the logics that I created, I will go for balance sheet. For secondary cost, I will go to the secondary cost. For profit and loss, I'll go to PL. So let's go with this balance sheet. Now system is telling me account group B is only defined for accounts from 100 to 299. So mistakenly I took this 2000. Actually, system is only allowing me three characters. So let me again go back to FS00. So instead of 2000, let's make it as 200. Okay, so click on new. GL account type is balance sheet account. Account group is going to be balance sheet. And here you will be providing the whatever bank details. Let's say this is my bank account. Okay. Let's go to the control data now. Now in control data, account currency, balance in local currency, there are a lot of things which are as it is. There is no change. Open item management, even this was available in SAP ECC also, but there was one more field, line item display. Okay, do you remember line item display? There is no line item display here. Okay, in SAP S/4HANA, for any GL account, you cannot click on line item display. What is the reason? Okay, before I tell you what is the reason, can you tell me what was the purpose of that field? For which GL accounts we were ticking that indicator and for which GL accounts we were not ticking it? Question is, line item display indicator was available in ECC here. What was the purpose of that? Anyone, please try to answer. Just make it interactive, because otherwise, if I keep on speaking, you may not be able to grasp the things. Prashant, you are very silent. Please answer this. Just try to answer. Yes, Prashant.
Yeah, could you repeat the question once more, please?
Prashant, my question is, there was in ECC when we were creating the GL account, there was open item management and there was one more field called as line item display.
Yeah, line item display, yeah.
Yeah, what was the purpose of that field?
Line item display. As of now, can't reproduce it, but actually I'm aware of open item management.
Okay, no problem. So I was just looking whether you are active on the call or not.
No problem.
Okay. So Mahesh, Sandeep, Akash, Varun, anyone, please try to answer this. I don't think this is very difficult question, right? All of you are working from many years in SAP ECC. So what is line item display?
I think system will show line-wise display. I think system will show line-wise display.
Where it will show?
Sorry?
Where you will be able to see line item display? In which report?
In report, FBL, like FBL1N, 3N, 5N.
Yes. Okay, so normally this is relevant for FBL 3N, because FBL 1N and 5N is not for GL, it is for vendor and customer. So for vendor and customer, line item display is always on. But this tick is for FBL 3N, to control FBL 3N. So if you don't tick that indicator, line item display, and if you go to transaction FBL 3N, and if you want to see all the line items posted in this GL account, you will get an error, line item display is not active for this GL, right? Now, why SAP has provided this option? Why not for all the GL accounts, line item display was on? Any idea? Why is it SAP was saying you have to tick this indicator if you want to go for line item display, otherwise it is not recommended for all GL accounts. Why it was not recommended for all GL accounts? Just a guess, why it was not recommended for all GL accounts? Just try to go back to our first session.
Because of the ledgers?
Sorry?
Because of the ledgers?
No, not exactly ledgers. In the first session, what we discussed, it was performance, speed. Okay. Right, and what we discussed is more data, less speed.
Okay,
so if you have many lines,
storage requirement, right?
Yes, storage. So if you have many lines available in your tables, let's say if you want to see FBL 3N in the lines, then obviously you have to tick that indicator. But that means that much number of line items will be stored in the table, which will consume your memory and your reports will become slow. And that is the reason SAP recommended that line item display should be only activated if you have a need to see the line item display report. It was not recommended for accounts like AR, AP. Why? Because AR and AP, anyways, you will be able to see the vendor-wise and customer-wise line items. So unnecessarily in FBL 3N, you don't need to set up that for the reconciliation accounts. So the whole purpose was just try to reduce the number of line items which are getting stored in the table and to improve the performance. But now, when we are talking about SAP HANA database, we already discussed those all kind of restrictions are gone. Because HANA database is very fast, even if you have million billions of lines, it will not